Onion rings and 2.5 cloves of garlic when I'm sure what to do with.
Good job, Hemp.
I'm breaking the diff!
Oh no.
My face.
Your face. He's famous.
Oh yeah.
Where are we?
A little place called Timber Creek. Just come out to some weird lookout. Pretty cool.
There's the town just there.
River down there.
Is that the Victoria River?
I think so. That's what it's called.
Beautiful.
On onion ring duty, trying to use all our food up before we cross the border tomorrow. Bloody good.
Not bad.
Just had a bake, onion rings, and 2.5 cloves of garlic. I'm sure.
Good job, Hem.
Walking back from Gregory's tree, big Boab tree on the Victoria River. Site where they set up a little town camp when they first came in.
When was that?
Just to tell you this, a bit more information.
Like a nice big tree, real old.
So when did they get there? They put in the dates
1855 they got there and they left.
1856.
But there's heaps of cool information there. It shows their little camp that they set up and their little horseshoeing area. Is that what it was?
No, it wasn't.
The twin trees. The twin trees.
Anything to do with that?
Anyway, if you're on this, if you're going this way, check it out. It's pretty cool. Every time we get back and she sees Dustin and Hannah, she's got to pick up something to give them as a gift. Today's leave. You have a strange dog.
Hey.
Get her off
her. How
are you doing? What have you got? Thanks. Oh, where'd it go? Thanks, Lulu. Hey. Have you ever seen a dog more excited to see their human?
Hey.
Just doing some side of the road modifications. We're driving along, we heard this funny noise coming from under the car, and Brenton thinks it might be the diff brake covers, is that right? Yeah, so we're just gonna take the wheel off and have a look at what's making the noise. We thought it might have been a rock or a stick stuck somewhere, but it doesn't seem to be, so fun. Help has come.
Loud though.
No, we weren't going as far, so.
True. Only cars could speak.
What's wrong, darling?
Like animals.
What's wrong, darling? I'm not feeling well.
It's not the trailer?
There's a stick in the tire of the trailer. Imagine if it's a stick in the tire of the trailer all this time.
No, it didn't sound like the trailer, but like...
It sounded different that time, Goo. Maybe it is the cover. The top bit's just still loose or something. What else could it be if it's not that? Down the bottom, looks like it's come loose.
What's happened?
What's happened, Ben?
The only thing I can think of is horrific noise coming out of the back end.
It was like a weird vibration, like...
Fine, it's loose.
It sounded like a stick stuck in the tire or something. Sounds better than before.
What's the thing?
Sound like, you know, sound like fucking a piece of wire in a tower shelf or something. Or like
just rattling with a
bearing or something.
It was like, yeah.
Like that. What's it? What's that?
It's the brakes.
Oh.
I only know that because I asked 10 minutes ago.
It just didn't look like it was meant to be there.
No, it attaches to the...
Yeah, maybe that was the problem. Maybe that thing's
Maybe that brake's falling off. Just dragging along there.
Faster. Hopefully that's all that the noise was.
Yeah, you can't really. Yeah.
We're job site supervisors. Oh, I missed him. Give it a kick for good luck, Dustin. Diana's done. Did you hear it just then?
On the driver.
Yeah, but like when you shake it, I couldn't hear anything.
It just sounds like something's like hitting.
No, when you put that in gear, it's like...
What does that mean?
Louder. You're not going to hear and just roll.
Oh, so it's something to do with the motor or something?
Oh, no. Some sort of... loose or... Why?
Yeah, right here on the highway. Taking the trailer off, taking it for a spin, see if it is the car or the trailer. And then we'll go from there.
Why can't help me?
Yeah, so you can definitely sound the difference.
Yeah, really don't live
it. What's the verdict?
I think I'm fucking broken the diff!
Oh no. So what's the plan?
Well, to start with, we're gonna... There's a bad noise coming out of the diff. I'm gonna take the tail shaft out of it just to really eliminate and see if it's definitely that making the noise.
Right.
And then, not really much we can do. Try get to Kununurra. Try drive there with it. If not, probably have to get towed.
Lucky we have that good NRMA cover, hey? It's all fun and games.
Now,
until...
Would have been, that little hill would have been exactly what would happen.
Yeah.
What happened? Did you hit it on the hill?
Oh, I stalled on the little hill.
And you would have really...
Oh, the weight pulled me back, but it was in gear, so I would have fucking...
I've been putting a lot of load on it, trying to go up the hill. It's like a little coming out of a creek.
Yeah, where we stayed last night. Come down a little hill onto the...
Jesus, stop.
There we go.
Just out here, middle of nowhere, and guy riding around Australia on a push bike's just overtaking us. Here we are, broken down. Done a diff. If we were in push bikes, you wouldn't do a diff. Well, we should be riding push bikes around Australia.
Bit of an update. Okay.
Oh, I was just trying to work, go through the NRMA process of getting towing, pay all this money for a big drama, but they reckon $2,500 to get it back to Catherine, or if it wanted to keep going to Kununurra, it's $4,500.
And we're about 200 k's from both. We're smack bang in the middle.
We'll just fucking drive in and get some parts and come back and fix it for $500.
Well, literally.
Just keep driving it. That's the next option.
What a pain in the ass. But NRMA is really confusing. You ring it and they put you on all these different people and closest depots and shit.
What the hell is going on in this bloody world? I think, I honestly think it's something to do with the pyramids.
It is sad. You pay all this money for this cover, and it's just... We can't get towed. Dustin, get off the road.
The truck coming.
Alright. 6:30, Saturday morning. Packing up and getting the tilt tray in to Kununurra this morning. Possibly broken a tooth on the crown wheel, the back diff. Anyway, we'll find out. Do they want to pull it out? Sunrise is bloody nice though.
On she goes. Not how we envisioned crossing the WA border. Stopping for a pie.
pie connoisseurs.
You know, for one toad restaurant.
Yeah.
My face.
He's famous.
Oh,
yeah. Mushroom for Duster today and
pepper.
Pepper?
Yeah.
Pepper and cheese and bacon for me today. Good temp. Good gravy.
Nice and peppery. I think so far the best thing about these pies is the intense flavours. The curry's curry and the pepper's pepper.
And no soggy bottom, which is nice.
That is such a dream. She's back, baby.
I mean, not really.
Not really.
She's on the ground.
Not working. We're here at the Ivanhoe Caravan Park. Craig, our tow truck driver, and his wife, Sue, manage the park. So, you're going to stay here. Brenton's sourced a diff, have you?
Oh, I think so, yeah. Yeah. I think we might find a few bits and pieces around here.
Find some bits and pieces from the towing place.
What's out here in Wilcannia.
We're not in Wilcannia. We're in Kununurra. So we're going to pull the diff apart and see what is the problem. And then we're going to go pick up a diff. And hopefully get it all sorted within the next day or two. So stay tuned.
We're going into Null's secret den of cars.
Yeah, what will we find?
Where are we? Up here somewhere. Stay tuned. getting it done.
Yeah, that's what we need there.
You gotta work for your parts, Eddie. Top dollar and you gotta remove them yourself.
We found a patrol. Should be the right bits we need. Goo's just removing the axles now, and then we'll pull the center out. And yeah, just here at Kununurra in the middle of the scrub. Yeah, getting a few parts.
It's been a big day. We've been up since 6 WA time, and then we lost an hour and a half over the border. Yeah. Love it. Successfully unbolted the diff center. We're just draining a little bit of oil out here. Oil looks like beautiful golden syrup, so things are looking good. What's happened?
What's the go with that? What's going on in there?
What's going on? Why are you making so many no- Right, so I'm just gonna give you a bit of a rundown on what's all unfolded here. So we're camped on the Victoria River, just this side west of Timber Creek, and we had to come up a little incline on the bank on the river where we camped down there, and I stalled it as I come up, and as I stalled it, all the weights shifted back and just grabbed the pinion in, cracked the teeth on the pinion. It's actually broken it. I did hit it with a hammer. Yeah, so anyway, we've broken the pinion and a bit of damage on the crown wheel. So yeah, instead of keep driving it, did get a tow truck. So before we left, we took out, well, we had NRMA complete care on the car, which gives you up to 150Ks free towing in remote areas and an extra $3,000 cover on top of that. So we're 210Ks out of Kununurra, and instead of breaking more stuff and worrying about it, we thought we'd use that, and it worked out pretty good. We just waited there and ended up picking us up the next morning. Yeah, it hasn't cost us anything. I think it's $214 for a whole year of cover, so it works out pretty good.
I did some research, and it was going to cost, what was it, $2,700 for a tow.
It's $2,700 for a tow from Kununurra and back, so it worked out good for that cover. So we pulled it all out, pulled the axles out, pulled the center out, and obviously we've broken the tooth on the crown wheel. We did hunt around. Bloke at the tow truck yard did have a GQ there, but then it had no centre. Had an early 3-litre GU, but it was the wrong diff, and we ended up finding another 4-1 centre in a later model series 4 3-litre, so it's the same 4-1 diff centre. So we're going to put that in. This is the air locker, it's all still good, so that was one of the other reasons I didn't want to keep driving it. I didn't want to damage the air locker rather than breaking more stuff. I just thought we'd get towed in and
use our cover that we pay for.
Use the cover. So I'm going to wrap all that up, and I'll just post that home and put that back in at some stage. We get home, I'll just run the LSD in here. That'll be fine to keep us going. So it's a bit of a rundown on what's happened.
So it's just throwing a little bit more grease in these wheel bearings.
It's not the...
The axle seals have leaked and washed all the grease out. But you need a press to get all the bearings and stuff out, so this is the best option.
So we're doing what we can.
Put a little needle on the grease gun.
Get a bit of grease in there. Should help the situation. Hopefully.
Hey, Brandon.
that's right, Jason.
Ideally, you would press them out.
Ideally, I'd like to press them off and redo them, but then you got to buy a whole new wheel bearing kit.
And you need a press.
You have a press or the tool. We have to make up a fucking tool to press them off. And
yeah, so this is what's going to happen.
This is how it's going to work. These bearings aren't even that old, so not they would be damaged. They just need a little extra grease.
And just repeat the same process on the other side. Chuck this one in and bolt it all together. Wow.
Boom.
So that's the axle bolted in to the center. And now put the disc back on.
Could do a clean up.
Hang on, fedora. It's a fedora. Put your fedora on, Goo.
What's this?
Give us a look.
Go up this way as well.
Oh, it's nice the other way.
Try and hold it up so that there is a seal, but it's pretty fucking heavy. Boom, baby. Start her up and put her in gear and see how many grinding noises it makes. Get some. Oh, oh yeah.